Hey guys, it's Awakened Gaming back here again with another tutorial. Today we're going to be taking some basic looks at Python programming. So, Python, as most of you know, is an extremely powerful scripting language. In my opinion, it's one of the best, and it's used for a very wide variety of things. Today, we're going to dip our feet a little ways in and learn some of the basics. So let's go ahead and get started. The first thing you're going to want to do is install it. I will show you how to install for both Linux and for Windows, but we will be doing most of the tutorial on Linux. So if you're using Kali Linux, it's already pre-installed for you. Just to make sure that it is, though, you can type in sudo apt-get update, excuse me, install Python 3. As you can see, it's already installed for us on this VM. And for Windows, you would just come to python.org/downloads, click on the download link, and it would begin downloading. Once it completes, you would just run the installer and go through it like you would installing anything else. So the next thing we're going to do is create a directory called Python. So we see our newly created Python directory. So now let's go to it and let's touch hello world .py. And we need a chmod a plus x world dot hello world dot py. And now, using whatever text editor you like, we will open up world.py. So you can do mousepad and then world.py. And at the beginning of the file, we need to type out this string to let it know that, to let the interpreter know that we're using Python 3 instead of Python 2. And as per usual with most programming languages, the very first thing you learn is how to make it print out hello world. But for Python, it's extremely easy. You can just print and inside we can do hello. I can type today. Control S, and we can cd over to, or we're already in our Python directory actually, or not. There we go. So dot forward slash world dot py, and we get hello world. Now, the next thing we will discuss are variables. So in Python, the way that you assign a variable is pretty simple. X equals hello. So you can think of variables basically as buckets that hold information. So this is how we assign it. We just state a number. It can be a number or a letter, but it has to be a letter before the number. So we could do something like x1 equals hello world, or an x2 equals world. Or we could just simply do x equals world, however you want to do it. And then if we print x plus w, or x plus x1 plus x2 rather, we should see hello world printed twice now. Hello world and hello world. If we cared about prettying it up, we could add a little space here. And now we actually get the space in. So that takes care of variables. The next thing, the let's go over some operators. So we can print. So operators basically are add, subtract, multiply, divide, and you can use those to do multiplication and also use them, slightly more advanced version of them, to pair things to each other. But just regular operators, we could do print 1 plus 1. We all know what that should come out to. 2. You could also do print 1 minus 1. Come on, 0, so on and so forth. So that takes care of operators. Next, we'll run over if-then statements, which are pretty easy in Python as well. So we can do for x in range of 10. So basically, we're just assigning x. We don't care what this is, it's x in range of 10. So basically this is going to count up, so x is going to be 1 to start with, then 2 all the way up to 10. And then we're going to print semicolons, print x then if x is equal to 5, then print x equals 5. So as we see, we 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and x equals 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So basically the way if statements work are if a condition is met, then it'll do whatever. So this was a pretty simple one. It just counted up from to 10, and while it was looping, it printed out what number we were on. And then once we hit 5, it printed this out and then continued on. So I know this was like an extremely simple version of how to use Python. In the next episode, we will be going more in depth. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. And if you did, feel free to drop a subscription. And as always, we have a Patreon page set up for you guys if you feel like supporting us. Thank you guys for watching, and be safe.